हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू अनदर ट्यूटोरियल। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल आई एम गोइंग टू मेक लेफ्ट आर्म असेंबली, लेफ्ट आर्म एंड दिस इज़ माय असेंबली। आई एम मेकिंग दिस असेंबली। इन फर्स्ट ट्यूटोरियल आई मेड दिस बेस एंड नाउ आई एम मेकिंग दिस आर्म। सो वी हैव अ डायमेंशन, यू कैन सी हियर, दिस इज़ द साइड व्यू, दिस इज़ फ्रंट व्यू एंड दिस इज़ टॉप व्यू। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द मॉडलिंग। Open a new page, model, millimeters and okay. First, let me zoom it so that you can see the dimension clearly. Okay, this is my view. So start, select a sketch and now it is asking you to plane. Now it is asking you for the plane. This is the plane YZ and okay. Select a circle and draw a circle here, two circles, one is bigger and one is smaller. The outer circle is radius 16, so I am assigning 30 mm diameter here, and the smaller one is 12 mm diameter, so drag the dimension outside. It is 12 mm diameter, so I am assigning 12 here. Okay. Now I am drawing the profile, this zigzag profile at once. So again select the profile, choose the point on a circle and draw your profile, the zigzag portion. Okay, again go to geometric constraint, select tangent constraint, select the circle, and second constraint should be this line, and now the line is tangent to the circle. And now the total length of this line, this horizontal line, is for 56, as you can see here. So for this, double click over the dimension to make it permanent 56. It is 135, so assign 135 degrees and drag this dimension outside. It is 60 but it is 86, so double click, edit the dimension, and the next is 110 mm, so 110, enter. Okay. Again, for assigning angular dimension, we have angular dimension command. This is the first line and this is second line. Drag the cursor in the direction of this taper line, and it is 30 mm in diameter. 30 mm in degree. As you can see here, it is 30 mm in degree, and it is there is a fillet at two places of 16 mm. So for this, select fillet, assign 50. It is 16 mm. Okay, it is 16 mm fillet. So assign 16 mm. Press enter. Select these two line and these two line as well. Okay. Now draw the upper section. Okay, now it's time to assign the dimension. Select constraint, select tangent constraint, select the circle and select this line for the constraint. The total length of this line is 43 mm. This horizontal line is 43 mm, assign 43 mm dimension, and this angled line is at the degree of 135. So for this, select angular dimension. Select these two line to assign degree dimension. Sorry, it is already 135, so it is not taking. It is getting over constraint, so I'm not applying tangent constraint here. This tapered line, angled line, is 83 mm. Double click to edit the line. Assign 83 mm. And we didn't have the dimension of this line, so I'm leaving it as it is. Let's draw this vertical line. Okay, extend the line. Okay, it is not extending. So it don't worry, drag this line up in up direction and select extend. Select this line to extend the dimension, and trim the excessive portion. Close. Now let me see which thing is left. Select trim command again. Select this circle. Okay, my sketch is fully constrained, but we have another circle, but we didn't have the dimension of this circle also. So I am placing a circle of 12 diameter at the center of this fillet. It is 12 mm diameter, and okay. There are two fillet over this tapered line of radius 8. So select fillet and assign 8 mm radius. Select these two lines and okay. My sketch is fully constrained, as you can see, with one auto dimensioning. Let me see whether something is left here or not. Everything is in the place. So finish the sketch and select extrude command. Now it is asking you to select the curve which you want to extrude, and the extrusion value will be, let me see first, it is 5 mm in thickness, so I am giving it 6, 5. Let me calculate it first. The extrusion value will be 11 mm because it is 6 and the rest is 5, so 6, 5 is 11. If you add 6 plus 5, so I am assigning 11 mm dimension. Boolean operation should be infrared, and apply and cancel. Now hide the sketch if you want to, by just right clicking and selecting the sketch and hide the sketch. Now I am going to make this half section, and I will cut that portion from this body so that we can get this zigzag type shape, because this arm have a zigzag type shape. Select a sketch again and choose this XZ plane and okay. Select the sketch profile. So guys, take line command and start making this section, as you can see here. So I am taking a point from here and draw a portion, as you can see I am drawing here. Okay, trim the excessive portion. Select a dimension, linear dimension, horizontal dimension. Select these two points. These two points are of 6 mm. And again, this sketch and this object point is 5 mm. As you can see here, the thickness is 5 mm and the width is width of this section is 6 mm, as you can see here. And now the total length is about 50 mm. So for this I am adding 50 mm here by selecting linear dimension. Choose vertical and select this vertical line, and it should be 50 mm. Okay, the dimension, the angular dimension is 135, as you can see here. So assign 135 here. Okay, and close. My dimension is completed almost. 50 mm, 135, 6 and 5. Okay, let's finish the sketch and select extrude command. Select the curve which you have sketched. Now drag the component, drag the extrude up to the next, and drag it backward as well by clicking over that point. The boolean operation should be subtract, apply and cancel. And now hide the sketch Okay, this is one side portion, and now it's time to make another side portion. So for this, select a sketch, choose this plane, this XZ plane for this sketch, and okay. Now, as before, as I draw this section before, draw exactly like this. Select the point, draw the section. Okay. Assign some dimension, select again linear dimension, select horizontal. These two points are 6 mm apart. Again, this point and this point is 5 mm. So it is already 5 mm, so it is showing over constraint. So undo the dimension and again select vertical dimension from linear dimension. It is about 52 mm in length, so I am assigning 52 mm for this dimension, this point and this point, 52 mm. Okay, cancel. Close. Select the angular dimension. The angular dimension is also 135 mm. Close. The next thing is select constraint. Select parallel. These two lines are parallel. They are already parallel, so it is not taking. I am selecting undo. Let me check it again. Okay, they are already parallel, so we don't need to apply this constraint again. Okay, my sketch is fully constrained. Okay, finish the sketch. Select extrude command, select that sketch which you have made, and drag this portion up to last, and select the boolean operation should be subtract from here, and apply and cancel. Now hide the sketch. Okay, this is my left arm, so we have to make this portion, as you can see here. It is, sorry, we are not taking left arm. This is our right arm. Okay, now it is exactly what I want. So for this, because guys, only dimensions are opposite, but the dimension are exactly the same, only you have to interchange these portions. So for this, I am just making one arm, and I will mirror this arm in the assembly by selecting mirror component. So I am making this right arm, and this have on the left side. So you may get confused when you will creating this drawing, you may get confused. So please read the dimension carefully and then start the drawing, because I am also getting confused whenever I saw this drawing again and again. Select this project curve to project these three curves and draw a vertical line. Trim the excessive portion again as I did before, and edit this dimension. It is about 5 mm in thickness, as you can see here. It is 5 mm in thickness, and now it is extruded about 43 mm. So what I am going to do, this is my 5 mm thickness, so I am selecting extrude, select the sketch, and this is 0, enter, and this is 43 minus 5, it will be 43 minus 5, enter, sorry, 43 minus 5. Okay, the boolean operation should be unite, because I want this should be the part of this, the entire body. Okay, let's hide the sketch. Now we have two fillet here, one is radius 4 and another is radius 8. So select edge blend, enter radius 1, 4, select this inner side edge, select apply. Now it's time to apply blend on the other side. Another side have 8 mm fillet, so apply 8 mm fillet over here, select apply and cancel. Actually we also have 4 fillet of radius 8, because we have 4 edges, 1, 2 and 3 and 4 on the other side. Select edge blend again, assign radius 8, enter, select this curve as well as this curve, select this curve as well as this curve. Okay, choose apply and cancel. Now the thing is, this is not a flat portion as you can see in my drawing, it is a curve portion. So how can we get this curve portion? We have an method to convert it into a curvy section. So I'm selecting edge blend again, assign 10 mm, because it is not given what radius this rounded portion have. So select these two small edges. Okay, 10 is okay in my sight. In my opinion, 10 is okay. So as you can see, my part is almost completed. Now the last thing is, if you want to assign the color, you can assign it. I am assigning it color. Let me select these 4 things. By pressing control key, select right, click right button. Now you can see there is an option of assign feature color in the property box. Feature face color. Now you can specify color as you want. I am specifying color. Let me assign some good color here. I think this brown color will be okay. Cancel. Select this extrude portion, right click, assign feature, specify this brown color, apply and cancel. I think it is okay, that color is okay, and it is depend upon you which color you want. You can assign the color as you want. So let's shade it. This is true shading. So I'm not going to make this right arm, this is my left arm, this is my right arm, and you can see the dimension is almost same. Only the difference is it is left sided and this is right sided. By this extruded portion, as you can see here. So I will mirror this arm in the assembly. So I'm saving it. You can save it by pressing Ctrl S. Okay, I am giving it the name right arm, R-I-G-H-T, right arm. Okay, so guys, I hope you like this tutorial, and if you like this tutorial, please like and subscribe our channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any video from our channel. Thank you.